myself and about what do I do and what my company is all about and APAC and what do all of that mean. So my name is Kunal Gupta. I was born in Jammu. I've been brought up largely in Delhi. I've done my engineering. It's been about 10 years in the industry that I've been working. My first job was with Birlasoft. Then I went to Adobe. After Adobe, I started my own company. I started a company by the name of Mount Talent Consulting. So it's been about 6 years odd that I've been running this company. In the process, I have went on to start about four companies. Mount Talent Consulting is one of them. Then we have a non-profit firm called Prashiksha Foundation. We have a company called the Academy for Learning and Employability, and we also acquired a 15-year-old NIT franchisee by the name of Mathly Infotech. We have an office in India, we have a setup in Middle East, and we have a small setup for US as well. So what we do really, I stay in Noida by the way, I have an office in Noida, and we cater to clientele worldwide from the setup that we have from Noida. So what typically we do is we hire for different companies. So I have about 9 business verticals, team of about 120 people, 120 consultants, a mix of engineers and MBAs. Now it's like an HR consulting firm which hires engineers. So probably some of you may ask why engineers and why not only MBAs? That is what we hire. Now we hire in 9 different verticals, 9 different business verticals. We hire in IT, in information technology. Information technology, we have 2 divisions. One is the product division, the other one is the software solutions division. We hire in manufacturing, we hire in FMCG, FMCD. We hire in engineering, procurement and construction industries, oil and gas now in Middle East, and education and publishing and a few other industries. So some of our clients include companies like Adobe, Amazon, InMobi, eBay, Flipkart, Citibank, American Express, KPMGs of the world and stuff like that. Now, what is so peculiar about these companies and why do companies probably use search firms for hiring leadership talent? Why do they use only so if in case I can understand the mix of the crowd, can you just guys give me an idea how many are first year students, how many are second year students, how many are undergraduate students? What is the mix of the crowd? How many are undergraduate students here? And you guys are doing BBA? Okay. And how many first year MBA students? And how many second year MBA students? Okay, good. So any other course which is here in the room? MCA. Okay. And any other course? These are the courses. So first year MBA students, I can understand that you are in your second semester. So from a business perspective, what exactly goes into making a company? Can somebody tell me how many divisions would typically be there in a company? So जैसे HR होता है, marketing होता है, कितने divisions होंगे एक company के अंदर? Just name them, raise your hands and just name them. Sorry? Finance is one of them. What else? Marketing is one of them. What else? HR is one of them. What else? R&D is one of them. What else? Operations is another one. What else? Production. Okay. So fundamentally, I'll give you an idea about how typically a company is structured, right? The first and the most important division for any company is the strategy division. The company which gives the team that gives the company the vision about what is to be done, how is the company going to go forward, is the company going to grow 15% per year? Is the company going to grow 100% per year? Is the company going to grow 2,000% per year? So it is that cream team which forms the strategy team of a company, which fundamentally defines what is the vision, what is the line of business that you're going to work in. Are you going to work into creating water bottles? Are you going to create into creating brass objects? Are you going to create furnitures? Are you going to do services like banking services? Are you going to do professional services? Are you going to do financial services? There has to be somebody at the top of the company, whether it's a CEO of a company, whether it's an MD of a company. Somebody has to define what the company has to do. How is the company going to go forward? Now, there are thousands of companies which are into software, there are thousands of companies which are into furniture, there are thousands of companies which are into electrical fans as well. However, somebody chooses a certain positioning in the market. Somebody wants to target only the luxury segment. Somebody wants to target only the middle class segment. Somebody wants to target only the mass segment. How do you create that categorization? Is there somebody else? Okay. So there is a certain level of categorization which happens in different companies at different times. And what companies typically expect is that people who join at the top league level, right? They have a certain say, a certain line of vision about what exactly is going to happen 5 years down the line, 10 years down the line. Is the company going to remain an SME? Is the company going to become a large company? What goes on behind the think tanks of IBMs of the world and Accentures of the world and Wipros of the world? What goes on into making these companies like they are? There are different categorization when you have leadership talent. How many of you scored 90% and above in your 10th class? Okay, how many of you scored above 80% in your 10th class? Okay, good. And how many of you scored above 80% from the same lot in 12th class as well? Right. And are there anybody from the MBA batch who cleared their engineering? Okay. And okay. So why I'm asking you these numbers is I'm just trying to give you an idea about the topic. So when we say attracting and retaining leadership talent, what does leadership mean in the first place? So if in case you go back to your schools and colleges in the graduation colleges, you know, the cream of your 10th class took science in the 10 plus 2. Your cream of the 12th class went into some of them, I'm not saying everybody, obviously the rest of you are here, but the remaining lot went to probably do their medicine, went to probably do their engineering. And even in engineering, only the cream top class went in to do probably an engineering from a top ranked IIT. Now, when somebody is hiring a company, you know, a few days back there was a news of WhatsApp being sold for $19 billion. Do you know the revenue of WhatsApp? It is making profits, but the kind of profit that WhatsApp is making is not even probably one by 1,000 of the valuation that it has been sold at. So what has gone into creating that kind of a valuation? What has gone into probably making Comb the kind of guy he is, that he's running a company like WhatsApp? Sorry? It is? Okay, popularity is a good thing, yes, but then you know, you want to create vision, you want to create long-term business continuity as well. Now, there's a friend of mine, his name is Abhishek Singla, IIT Kanpur guy. He used to run a company called LearnHub. LearnHub got acquired by Educom Solutions. I don't know how many of you have used Jumbo Test or LearnHub as a portal. Are there any people? Only 2-3 of you. So LearnHub was probably India's largest website when it came to number of clicks and number of hits, the largest community in education. However, it could not translate into revenues. On the other hand, you have sustainable models like those of NIT, somebody who has been a market leader for about 30 years now. Since 1982, NIT has not seen a loss in the education business. You have a company like ILNFS, a market leader today, somebody who has really redefined how National Skill Development Council is reshaping the education platform in this country altogether. How many of you want to be leaders here from this room? Okay, okay, guys, I think you really need to wake up. You're here for a leadership questionnaire here, right? You're here for discussing on leadership. You're here to listen on leadership. How many of you really want to be leaders here? Okay, what about the rest of you? What do you want to do? You want to be like an average guy, you want to just pass off and, you know, you just want to pass off like the world didn't know you. You just want to shy off. You don't want the world to notice you. None of you is the remaining lot who did not raise the hands. You don't want the world to notice you. Do you like when somebody appreciates you, that you have dressed well, you're looking good, you've scored well, you've done this subject which is done nicely? So why would you not want to be leaders? You're barely 20 odd somethings, right? Probably 19, 20, 21 years of average age in this room. if in case you don't have the zeal to achieve something, you'll not go anywhere. The zeal for leadership, the guy who cracked that IIT, and you know, in IIT, half the class doesn't crack a 7 CGPA. In that class which cracks 7 CGPA in an IIT or an IIM, right, probably barely 5% of them crack through the top league companies, which include McKinsey's of the world, Merrill Lynch of the world, the top investment bankers. That is what makes leadership talent in this, anywhere in this world. WhatsApp is WhatsApp because a guy could think 5 years hence. You know, I used to hire for Adobe about 7 years back, and I had hired the entire team which had written Microsoft Office 2007. Microsoft Office 2007 was written, it was designed starting 2002. Today, in 2014, my laptop still has an Office 2007, which I use. The guy who wrote the specs for Microsoft Office 2007 is a real leader for me, because he wrote the features which are irreplaceable, which are, there is no competition to those features which were written in 2002 sitting in 2014 today. But that's leadership for you. The guy who designed the first wireless set for Motorola in 1973, he doesn't know where all and how long have we come that today we are sitting as a result of mobile and internet revolution in this room. You gotta have a zeal in yourself. If in case you don't have a desperation to achieve something, you don't want to be a leader, you will not become them. An A guy hires an A guy, a B guy hires a C grade guy hires a D grade guy hires an E grade guy. You have to be in the league of the A grade guys only if in case you ever want to really know the meaning of what is a leader. All those guys who have probably stretched out themselves, stretched themselves out totally, would know what is the meaning of going from 80% to 90% or 90% to 95%. It's not easy. For a company as well, it is even more difficult first to attract people. Now, you know, Mayank Jindal, he is one of my friends. He is probably one of the biggest yarn guys in this country, one of the biggest yarn manufacturing guys in this country. He runs a family business in Ludhiana. And he used to study in SRCC with me. I have never seen that guy go to college. Still, he scored 72.6% in SRCC. He did not get any teaching from SRCC, right? But he's a guy who will not score anything less than 72%. And all those who have studied from Delhi University would know what a BCom honor 72% guy is, right? Without studying. So it's not about an IIT, just about creating an IIT. Or it's not about a huge differentiation that an IIM provides or an IIT provides. Probably you have had the best faculty here. And you would never even know that these guys put more effort than probably the faculties who are there in an IIM or an IMC or an SP Gen or KJ Sumayas of the world and any other college. But it is about you. You know, I'll tell you what, I can put 10 IIT guys, right, and I can give them a business problem, not an engineering problem, and I know all of them will solve it without any guidance, because that is the attitude which makes them who they are. They don't require teaching. You know, there is something about leadership, there is something about quality, there is something about perfection which you cannot teach people at all. I'll be really surprised if in case any one of you says that you don't like recognition. Do you not like appreciation? You like it when somebody appreciates you, when somebody likes you, when somebody recognizes you, when you are in the thick of things, when you are in the spotlight. That is leadership. You know, you put 10 people, right? How do you attract leaders? A leader can be attracted only to another leader. You know, he will never get attracted. I used to hire for BirlaSoft many years back, about 10 years back now. And I had a question to my boss. His name is Narendra Pupala. He was one of the co-founders of Career Launcher. So I asked him, why don't we hire IITs and BirlaSoft can transform itself from being an ordinary company to probably something like a Microsoft someday? He said, the kind of work that we do is not first of all going to attract IITians, neither is it going to retain them. I can hire them, but I will not be able to retain them because the quality of work and the kind of people that we have do not provide a challenging scenario for people to thrive in such an environment. So it's not just about the work that you want to give people. It is also about the kind of ecosystem, the kind of space that you want to create. if in case 95% of you don't want to become leaders, do you know what will eventually happen? You will not become them. You are here, there are people who have done a lot of sacrifices in many of your cases for enabling you to sit here on the very chair that you're sitting here, by the way. And I'm sure many of you have stretched yourselves to reach wherever you are right now. Don't do just time pass. I mean, you're not here for simple time pass here. You want to become a leader, become one. And the time is only now. If in case you're not a leader in a business case study which is given to you by your faculty, if in case you're not a leader in the kind of work, in the kind of research, in the kind of initiatives, in the kind of extra work that you're trying to do and trying to put together for stretching yourself in terms of learning your subject, there is only so much so that you can learn from a book. There is only so much so that you can learn from a teacher. You got to ask the right questions. And if in case then your teachers don't answer, then go out to the world and learn it. You know, one of my best teacher has been a guy, his name is Praveen Chandra. He's a faculty in the university school of information technology in the Press University. Now he turned out to be one of my best teacher and one of the biggest learnings that I had from him. So what happened is I had to do a summer internship project and I went to him to choose a topic. He said there is a topic called Mandelbrot sets, fractals or Mandelbrot sets. It's a mathematical equation. In case most of you have seen screensavers which have those diagrams which keep rotating themselves over and over and over again. So those are typically Mandelbrot sets or fractals. So he told me go to the Central Science Library in Delhi University. Wahan jaake third floor pe chala ja, seventh floor pe chala ja. Ye ek ek book hai, ye leke aaja. Aur iska 11 chapter hoga, 13 chapter hoga, wo photostat kara ke pad lena. So I read it. I said samajh nahi aaya. So he said tune 11th chapter pad liya lekin pehle ke 10 kon padega. So I had to go back again, reread the book. I spent about 15 days reading all the books and then again I did not understand. So he said, you're not going to understand in theory, why don't you write a few programs and then understand. So in a period of 2 months, right, what I realized is all I need is the right guidance and the right mentorship. And for that also, I have to take an initiative of going to that mentor and asking him what exactly is it which is going to fulfill my, what exactly is going to challenge me enough for me to stretch myself. That's one of the examples from my life which really, really taught me on the value of a good teacher. Another example is when I was a computer science guy. I was one of the university toppers in Indraprastha University and I had a paper on human cybernetics. How do you integrate silicon chips inside a human brain? And this was way back in 2004. I still don't see that kind of work and I thought that I'm probably not even amongst the top 50% there. You know, one of the learning that I had is and the reason why I left that field is I realized that I can't code 18 hours, I can't research 18 hours, I can't research 20 hours. Identify that for yourself as well. If in case there is something working, something that you have a zeal and a passion for, identify it right away. You know, for me to give you examples of companies and how they recruit people and how they attract people and how they retain people is pretty easy. But you would not get it because till the time you're not going to implement it on yourself. How do you get attracted? You know, okay, I need some volunteers. Can I have a couple of volunteers here? Nobody wants to volunteer here? You want to volunteer? Okay. So you are a first year student of MBA or second year student of MBA? You're a second year student of MBA. Who was the best student in your class? First, in terms of everything, somebody who was not a bookworm, but somebody who was a proper leader, somebody who was great on extracurricular activities, somebody who was great on studies, somebody who was great on good personal relations.
Sir, in our college, we have a portal system. No.
Forget about any system. You okay. Tell me yourself personally. Whom do you think was the best?
Shalini Jha. She was best because she got the highest.
Okay. She was the best. Was she strong on extracurricular activities?
Yeah, she was.
She was. Is Shalini your friend?
Yeah, she is.
Good friend?
Yeah, she is.
You have better friends than Shalini?
Yes. That's fine.
You have. So you know, it's a very basic thing. Good, thanks. Anybody else? Anybody else who wants to volunteer? So who do you think from your 12th class was the best student of your class?
I don't remember actually.
Who was the best? Who was the real best in the class?
Cheshta.
Cheshta. Are you in touch with her?
No.
You're not in touch with her at all. Right? Do you don't know what happened after 12th?
No, she has done MB graduation. She has done BBE.
Okay. Thank you.
That's all.
So the reason why I'm highlighting this example is, you know, everybody knows who is the best. Fundamentally, honestly, whether you like that person, you don't like that person, you know who is the best. You may want to admit it. You may not want to admit it. But you would always know who is the best and whether you are the best or you are not the best. And you would always cherish if at all you have a conversation with that person or if in case somebody is leaving behind some or the other inputs in you that are helping you grow as a person, helping you grow as a student, helping you grow as a professional. Right. The reason why you need to be aware of this factor is that there is something about that person and there is something which is missing. There is something which is definitely missing, right, where you are. Not that you are not a leader in yourself, but there is something fundamentally missing in who you are and where you are, that you are not in that league or you are not that person that you can name yourself, yes, I was the guy. Have some conviction, don't have modesty. It is not, modesty is not going to take you anywhere. Nobody else is going to cover for you. Agni Yogina, if in case you don't have your life online, you will not understand the meaning of leadership. You are 19 year olds, 20 year olds, amazing amounts of energy levels. Why is it said that youth can change the world? Is because aap aag laga sakte ho. You can really put fire on any system. It was not a joke for the guy sitting at the back. You know, understand the gravity of it. If in case at this stage, you are not going to focus on what you have to study right, what kind of basics you want to form. In the next few years, these are the very same things which are going to haunt you. You got to be clear, you want to be a guy who just wants a happy-go-lucky life, or you want to be a guy who wants to be successful in life, somebody who wants to achieve something big. You got to start it now. You know, some of the top research firms employ summer interns who come from the top B schools and the top engineering colleges only because of the fact that they see a lot of great seed. They see great enthusiasm for people that they can caution. They can set the right things. They come with fresh set of ideas. You know, don't let your talent go wasted. Right. So I'll still also give you an idea about what companies typically do to attract and retain the top talent. The first thing first, which a company has to do in attracting and retaining top talent or top leadership, is about creating an environment. It's about creating the right set of challenging problem that a business is going to solve, which is going to attract people to apply for that company, to come into that company. What kind of space is the company creating? What is the space of intellect in the company? What is the space? What kind of conversations are happening in the company? What kind of discussions are happening in people in the company? What are people up to in the company? Right? These are very, very important questions and they show. Right? Say, some of you might have done your summer internships in some large corporates. You know, the culture of that company is so starkingly on the face as soon as you enter from the gate of that company. And in many cases, it is not so obvious. But there is something that has gone into creating that culture that as soon as you enter, the air hits you about what exactly is the culture the company has. Some companies, ILNFS of the world, Ranbaxy's of the world, right? Companies, jahan pe banda 10 saal se, 15 saal se, 20 saal se kaam kar raha hai. It's not that he's got bored out of it, or you know, he's useless, that is the reason he cannot apply, but there is something that gets into building people in these companies which is not so easy to replicate with others. Why do you think IBM has been a leader in IT all these years? Yes, they have lost out on many assignments. Yes, they have lost out on relational databases to Oracle. Yes, they were instrumental in creating companies like Oracle and companies which were into a lot of database consulting of the world and stuff. But they have been leaders. For being a leader, you got to be open to take chances. You got to be open to take changes. When Jack Welch opened Genpact or GE as an outsourcing hub, when he started outsourcing, you know, it was a big no word in US. People didn't want to hear him. People disliked him. There were huge number of litigations on him that he's passing off work from US to other countries where it is done at low cost. But you got to think 5 years hence, you got to think 10 years hence. Agar aap log aaj jo chahiye wo karoge, to aap race se chhut jaoge, because jo banda aage ja raha hai wo kal ke bare mein soch raha hai. You know, when WhatsApp was started in 2009, the guy thought of probably the easiest solution which could enable maximum number of people to come on his platform at the earliest. He could think of nothing else than address books. He thought mere paas ready made database hona chahiye. You know, somebody had to break that problem. BlackBerry. What did BlackBerry do wrong? BlackBerry still has probably the finest technology. BlackBerry 10 jo platform